So what gave you the idea for Operation Love, Mary Lane?
Well, what gave me the idea for Operation Love, Mary Lane is that I went to Guadalajara to visit a friend, and we went down this to a small village outside Guadalajara and to a lake. And as soon as I got off the bus, inside the bus station, there were street dogs. There was dogs everywhere. And on the road down to the lake, they had these little taco stands. And all the street dogs would come up to the taco stands, hoping that somebody would just drop some food for them. I saw this poodle that was covered in ticks and fleas, and it had a broken leg. And it was up on the table asking for food, and it didn't face anyone. I saw this dog go by that was completely covered in mange. It had very little hair at all, and it was scratching itself so raw that it was dripping blood. And I sat there and I watched this dog drink this dirty water and bleed in so much pain. And it just walked right by everybody. And you know, when I took pictures of the dog, what caught the people off guard was that I was taking a picture of it. That the dog itself, that was in this tremendous amount of pain, didn't faze anybody. What fazed people was that I cared enough to take a picture of it. Operation Love Mary Lee is we're going down to Tijuana to some of the poorer neighborhoods, and we're gonna catch and we're gonna spay and neuter 100 street dogs, and we're also gonna vaccinate them, medicate them. Some of the sicker ones we're gonna raise funds for to see if we can get them to foster and take care of some of the ones that are really sick. Can help by going on to our Facebook. We've set up a Facebook group, Operation Love Mary Lee, and also we have a website, youcaring.com, and we've set up where you can just click and you can donate online, because we really do need funds for the medication and the fostering. All the rescue groups in Tijuana are overwhelmed. The need is so great and the resources are so little. So if anyone can donate, we really do need help. Other non-cash items that we need are dog food. We need flea and tick treatment. We need vaccinations. We need blankets, towels, and you know, just basic stuff. I've heard some of from the dogs in Tijuana that the people are so poor that they put chains around them because they can't afford leashes and collars. So basically it's everything. We need everything. And we'll take anything. I got attacked by a few people asking, why am I helping the dogs over there? I should be helping the dogs here. And you know, I try to explain, you know, a dog doesn't care where it's at. A dog that needs help, needs help. And I was viciously attacked by a few people, and you know, I blocked them from Facebook. And I had this beautiful soul from New York. She said that she saw what we do and how we help the animals, and that when she goes to Mexico on vacation, how heartbroken she is, and she comes back heartbroken because she has to feed the dogs. She spends her vacation feeding the dogs, and she says she has very little hope when she comes back from Mexico, and she sees how much we do on so little, and that she wanted to give us some money. So as a way of honoring what they have done for me, I'm turning around and I'm doing something bigger than anything that we've ever done before. So we've named Operation Love Mary Lee after Mary Lee, and I have great hopes. I have great hopes, and it's so nice how so many people are pulling together.